Omar with IFL TV MTK Global, joined by the legend.
Legend, ooh.
Boxing legend, that is Asghar Tehr.
Oh, I don't know about legend, but I'm there.
Asghar, we've seen Tyson Fury cause an absolute ruckus in America, not with anything to do with boxing, but the WWE. It seems like a match made in heaven.
Listen, what PR is that? Unbelievable. He looks happy as hell. His popularity is already quadrupled overnight. It's just a great, great move. And just to see him in that state of mind, his kids are there, his wife's there, his family's all there, having the great, greatest time of their lives. This is what it's all about. It shows you how popular, what a sporting icon Tyson Fury is. It's brilliant.
Do you think he's the most popular heavyweight in America?
In the world.
No, but I'm talking because obviously you've got Deontay Wilder there, an American
WWE. Deontay Wilder's not that popular. We've been there. You've seen the live videos we've done. He's building. But Tyson Fury, he's a megastar now. He's on that level of Cristiano Ronaldo, the Lionel Messi, sporting icons. He's right up there.
Conor McGregor, probably another name up there.
Yeah, but you can't knock Conor McGregor because he's up there. Tyson Fury is definitely up there, and I put him right up there.
Well, the last person I saw in a boxer I saw in WWE was Floyd Mayweather, wasn't it? Am I wrong in saying that?
He set it in motion.
Ricky Hatton did it. Muhammad Ali did it.
No, but the last one I saw was Floyd Mayweather.
Last heavyweight, I believe, was Leon Spinks.
Was it Leon?
Was actually world champion boxer and world champion wrestling.
Was he?
Yeah.
What, he's a wrestling world champion?
Yeah.
Didn't know that.
No, yeah. Neither did I.
Check you out.
There you go, man.
Well, maybe Tyson could do the same as Leon then.
Hey, he's definitely got a life after boxing. 100%.
No, that'd be perfect for him because that'll fit him perfect with him. Perfect. The WWE.
Absolutely,
inside.
Yeah.
Listen, he needed to keep busy.
Two great sports.
He's healing from a cut. What a way to keep busy. What a way.
You know, it's on Fox as well. That's Deontay Wilder's station, isn't it?
Yeah, and the wrestling, look, did you hear about the paper? Is it the views was massive? It was like second biggest I've ever
spoke
had.
To Paulie. Apparently he's like went to 4 million homes.
Wow.
So Paulie Manilagi said that, yeah.
It shows you, he's just getting bigger and bigger, and he's likeable. He plays the part to the T. Look, Braun Strowman, who would have thought of that?
Yeah.
Come on. But he was. Listen, I'm not a WWE fan. Well, I wasn't 2 days ago, but now I'm a massive fan.
Yeah, but your son would have something to say about that since he's a massive
fan.
Oh,
my son can't stop talking about it. He's loving it. When I was showing him, he's like, "That's Tyson Fury," and I was like, "Oh my god!" I was glued to it. I was like, "Give me the phone, give me the phone. Let me have a look." It was just brilliant. Great to see.
Right, Asghar, I do want to take your mind back to Vegas. Fury Wallin.
Yep.
A lot of cries from Team Wallin. They want a rematch with Tyson Fury.
For what reason?
What do you make of that?
Listen, they're going to try anything to get an extra payday. Listen, fair play to the man and poor soul because his father passed away.
Mm.
And it's so sad he kept going. Listen, he gave it his all, but he's coming short. The cut changed the whole plan. But with a massive cut like that for another 10 rounds, you couldn't finish him off. Listen, you would definitely finish off Tyson Fury when he's beat. It was 10-2 in rounds. If you look at the fight, exclude the cut, Tyson still did okay. And listen, you've got to understand how smart he was, how he covered that cut. Played it very, very, very smart. Great boxing. I enjoyed it. I watched the fight over and over again, even without the volume. It was brilliant. It was clever of Tyson.
Some people suggesting that if Wilder was in the ring that night with Tyson, it might not have gone Tyson's way.
But that's like saying, you know, you can say anything. What if?
He raises his game, though, when he...
Tyson always raises his game. It was just a free cut. The cut happened, and even Wallin couldn't catch... He couldn't finish off or cash in on that cut. And that shows you Tyson's IQ level. He knows how to play, cover up, and make you miss. He's healing well. That's the main thing. He's had plastic surgery, so it's great, over 50 stitches. And he will be ready February 22nd, hopefully.
You've been in his corner for God knows how long.
Long time,
you weren't there, which was a shame. But Jorge stepped in, did a brilliant job.
Yeah, Jorge is a very, very nice man. Under a lot of pressure, did what he needed to do. Listen, the team did what they needed to do, and it was great. At the end of the day, Tyson got the win. You know, everybody played a part. It was just a great result. Great atmosphere. Cut dampened the mood a bit, but it is what it is. And these things happen. No, you can't go swimming and not expect to get wet. It's boxing. And look, like Tyson said, what did Tyson say? I fight for this kind of stuff, you know what I mean? It was great.
Are you going to try and get out for the Wilder fight in Vegas?
Yeah, we're sorting things out at the moment in the process, trying to clear up what needs to be cleared up. I'm on the phone to Ben every day, so hopefully things get sorted and off I go, hopefully.
What's Ben up to? Like, he's obviously on a break. He's been working with Tyson non-stop.
Ben, Ben can't live without boxing. Ben is boxing. He's always on the I'm always on the phone to Ben because he's a guy, you can't help but pick his brain. Right, Ben, what do you think of this? Ben, what do you think of that? And he's like, yeah, you should do this. And I take everything he says, I listen, because the man's so young, but he's so smart. And you can never, it's like when I used to take Shabazz over, and he said, Asgi, right, try this. Asgi, try that. You know, this kid's really special. And I was like, okay, right, go to this place. And what he said has worked. And you see what Shabazz is now. He's on the Frank Warren undercard, you know, Josh Warren undercard. So the people.
Yeah,
I've,
not Frank. Frank ain't fighting. Yeah, so not anyway. Although you never know, Nigel Benn's making a never return. So.
Ben's just a boxing man through and through.
Still think Frank could beat Eddie.
Yeah, Ben's just a boxing man through and through.
He'll set the battle.
Imagine the amount of pay-per-view numbers that would do. My God. What channel would it be on, though? That would be a problem, wouldn't it? The way boxing's gone this year, don't rule it off for next year.
Don't write it off.
Put it on IFL. Yeah. There's one more thing I need to ask you as well.
Yep.
Please. Gone. It's gone. Come on, throw things at me. Okay. So, a bit of a delicate one. John obviously had a little outburst at Ben. He was working on
Absolutely.
The broadcast of BT. Where do you think that came from?
Listen, he's a father. He's seen his son cut. You know, John, very, very passionate, very close with his family. And like any father, he'd be concerned. And obviously, John's very emotional. And he said what he needed to say. But you don't take that personal. You know, it is what it is. He said what he said. But Ben's above that. Ben knows what it's about. It's nothing personal. It's a spare the moment thing. People have jumped on it. Ben, John, Tyson, it's all one. It's nothing, believe me. It was just an emotional thing. Me watching it from home, and I was like, bloody hell, oh my God. But you've got to see how cool, calm Ben did. Kept him calm, stuck to the game plan. It was a cut. Forget the cut, Tyson still did what he needed to do. People just jumped on it, and you know, it's sad, really.
Okay, Esky, thank you very much for your time. See you in Nando's on Friday, all right?
Definitely.
Tank up.
Yeah.
See you, Shabazz.
And Mike.
Sir, thank you very much.